AFTV, I've got Tim Payton with me from the Arsenal Supporters Trust. I haven't seen you for a long time, Tim, so it's great to catch up with you, but not under these circumstances. Of course, the big discussion has all been about this brand new European Super League, which Arsenal have signed up to along with 12 other clubs, six Premier League clubs, including Tottenham, Manchester United, Manchester City. You know, I've got to get your view on it. What have you made of the whole situation, and what have people been telling you? I know that loads of fans will be, you know, coming to you for you know, with their reactions and want to find out what can be done.
It's just deplorable, absolutely deplorable. The AFT completely opposes this. It's the death of football as we know it, isn't it? Mm. Football is based on competitive balance, qualifying for competition through your performance, not through some carve-up in JP Morgan Bank about who the best club is. So we have already put out a very strong statement. Last night, I mean, usually they're our enemies, but we were talking to the Spurs Trust and Chelsea Trust and Spirit of Shankly. We're all united on this. We were talking to number 10 last night. The Prime Minister has come out saying he's against it. We have to look at what he can do. Can they introduce regulation? Should they levy a super tax on these so-called super clubs to take away their greedy profits? We've got to get government thinking about the German model, you know, where fans are involved in their clubs. And we've also got to work with the Premier League and the FA and UEFA, because, you know, people say, oh, you want Arsenal kicked out. I don't want Arsenal kicked out. I want Arsenal to stay in. But that means obeying by the rules they signed up with, not acting disgracefully. And as you probably know, any player who plays for a scab club or a club that's broken away from the league can't represent England in the summer. There is lots and lots to come on this. But my message to all Arsenal fans, to all AFTV listeners and everybody else is raise your voice and act. But it's not the next 24 hours. This is going to go through the courts. This is going to go through football arbitration. This is going to have the government looking at it. And we must not give up until we've seen it off. And I think it's going to be a campaign over the weeks and the months. When we are allowed back here, we've got to come back. We've got to think about that creatively. How do we protest? How do we bring banners? Do we go in or not? What do we say when we do? I think those are discussions and debates that all Arsenal fans should have together.
What's the part of it? What's the part of this whole Super League thing that really you just look at and say, no, I'm just totally against it? Because it is what they're trying to do. It is like an alternative to the Champions League, basically, isn't it?
The absolute number one thing. How can I, as a football fan, look a Leicester fan in the eye and say we should go in this Super League and you shouldn't, when they've been obviously a better football team than us this year? Of course I want Arsenal in the Champions League every year. I want them one day, it seems like a dream at the moment, I want them one day to think about winning it, but I want them to do it on merit. I want them to do it by building a good enough team to get in the competition and win it. It would be hollow. It would be empty to win the thing when you've come ninth in the Premier League. I also want enough resources shared around the Premier League so you get competitive fixtures. We don't like drawing with Fulham, but if we knew we were guaranteed to beat Fulham, it wouldn't be that exciting to watch, would it? So the absolute number one disgraceful thing here is guaranteed entry. It's the American franchise model. We always feared it, didn't we? Cronky came in as an investor.
It's like a NFL.
Yeah,
isn't it?
You're rubbish, but here you go again next year, start again. He's guaranteed a big payout from JP Morgan. Incidentally, you know who's led the negotiation with JP Morgan? Our old friend, or I wouldn't call him our friend, Ivan Gazidis is the absolute snake.
He was also negotiating
the absolute snake in
he?
The heart of all of this. And Milan, I mean, when did Milan last qualify for the Champions League on merit? But he's stuck them in there. It's just the death of football as we all know it and love it.
So, has there been any sort of planned protests or anything like that? Because, you know, a lot of people have been asking me, you know, what can we do to stop this? You've named out some of the things there, but they've been very calculated with this, isn't it? Because they've come out and they've made this announcement.
Spurs sacked their manager today to distract the news.
Very coordinated though, wasn't it? Every single club that was involved in it put it on their website last night. And of course, there are no fans here to protest or to walk out or to say that, you know, they're going to... There's not a lot we can do at the moment, is there?
Well, I think what we can do is raise our voices on social media and to the press and the politicians. And actually, I've been very heartened. You know, you look at the front pages today, you look at the media comment. The politicians, the Prime Minister, the Secretary of State, the opposition are all saying, no, we will join with you in fighting this. So we can do a lot. We don't even know when we can come back here. Possibly on May the 17th or around about then for a game against Brighton. We have to take it, I think, a day at a time. I'm talking to the other major trusts, I'm talking to supporter groups, the FSA, the FSE, they've all got a role. But for now, I would say use social media, contact your MP, contact the club, tell them you won't have it, tell them you don't want to renew. It's not Arsenal's values. And what would Herbert Chapman be thinking? You know, what would the greats, what would even Arsene Wenger be thinking? People who understood that football, it's supposed to be a club. We're supposed to be a part of a community, and they're ripping it out. So some American investor who doesn't come here, doesn't talk to us, doesn't care about us, can just get richer and richer.
Yeah, I was going to say, obviously, I know you get to, you know, attend meetings, well, when they used to have the meetings, but if anybody's going to get a chance to talk to the hierarchy here about these sort of things, it will be somebody like you and your organisation. Was there any inkling of this? Has there been anything said to you guys that something like this might happen?
There's been a lot of inkling from the general football community, and we knew that the European Club Association had a big meeting last week and UEFA was going to sign off the Champions League, and we've been involved in campaigning on that. We've tried to talk to Arsenal on this over the last few weeks and they've gone to ground, and over the last week we requested meetings and correspondence until we got nothing, until late last night, you know, after the statement came out, the offer of a phone call. But I've also got to remember, I think, that this isn't made in Highbury House. This is made in Denver. This is made in a guy who's always shown contempt for us. How many times has Stan Kroenke met an Arsenal fan or addressed Arsenal fans? Zilch. Never. That's where this is dreamt and made up. We must challenge the people who work at the club, but we've got to also use the legal structures, the government structures, the media structures, so that the message gets through to Denver and in other places.
I just want to ask you one last thing, right? What sort of pressure do you think that puts on, say, a Mikel Arteta? Because ultimately, press conferences this week are going to be very interesting. They're ultimately going to be asked that question. He's in a difficult position, is he? The manager, he's...
Does he have integrity? If he has integrity, he'll speak out for the values of the game. There are more senior managers that in some ways have got bigger pressure. I mean, I am a huge admirer of Jurgen Klopp, including the way he believes in fans and community and everything. And, you know, all the German clubs, interestingly, didn't go with this. Yeah. What's Klopp going to say? I will give great credit that last night, straight out the block, Sir Alex Ferguson, despite the fact he's on the board of Manchester United and those links, attacked it as completely against everything.
He's not managing at the moment. Believes
it. He's not, but he's a really powerful voice, yeah, yeah. I think, there.
Yeah.
Oh, I agree. And they've got to be put under pressure, as have the players. But the players, you know, if they want to take the money off JP Morgan, then they're no longer, you know, true representatives of the fans. They've got to stand up for something. They won't be allowed to play for their country either if they want to play for a scab league. So this is gonna roll out. But there again, and this is why it's so dispiriting, what does it matter? It doesn't matter whether Arteta comes 12th or 8th or 4th or how the players perform or we upset them, because they're in this Super League anyway. The whole thing's dead as it stands, so we've got to fight it hard.
Thank you, Tim.